In the preceding video, all of the division involving fractions resulted in whole numbers. This video will illustrate division of fractions when the result, the quotient, is not a whole number. Sometimes the quotient will be a mixed number, and sometimes it'll be a fraction. And we will see examples of word problems that involve two different concepts of division. We will also look at the common misconception among students that division always makes smaller. If a sugar maple tree gives 1/3 gallon of sap each day, represented by the shaded amount of this 1/3 bar, how many days will it take to obtain 5/6 gallons of sap, represented by the shaded amount of the 5/6 bar? So we want to compute 5/6 divided by 1/3, and we can see that the shaded amount fits in once, twice. So the shaded amount of the 1/3 bar fits in more than 2 times and less than 3 times. Let's compute the answer. 5/6 divided by 1/3 equals 5/6 times 3 equals 15 over 6. 6 parts in a whole bar, so we're going to have 2 whole bars and 3/6, which is 2 1/2. So it's going to take 2 1/2 days. This answer makes sense because when the shaded amount of the 1/3 bar is fit into the shaded amount of the 5/6 bar, the remaining amount of the 5/6 bar is 1/2 the size of the 1/3 bar. Let's look at another example where the quotient is not a whole number. This time we'll use 7/12 bar and a 1/4 bar. If the school track is 1/4 mile long and Gail runs 7/12 of a mile on this track, how many times will she run around the track? So we want to compute 7/12 divided by 1/4. Now we can see this amount, the 1/4 fits in there once, twice. This would be 3, so it's more than 2 and less than 3. So let's compute this amount. 7/12 divided by 1/4 is 7/12 times 4. That's 28 over 12. So each part of a whole bar has 12 parts. We're going to have 2 whole bars and 4 more parts. And so this equals 2 1/3. So this is 2 1/3 times around the track. Notice from the bars that 2 1/3 times makes sense. The shaded amount of the 1/4 bar fits in once, fits in twice, and the remaining amount of the 7/12 bar is 1/3 as big as the shaded amount of the 1/4 bar. In the examples in this video and in the previous video, we have determined how many times one amount fits into another. In dividing 7/12 by 1/4, we see that 1/4 fits in once, twice, a little bit more than 2 times. This type of division can also be viewed by thinking of subtracting or measuring off 1/4 from 7/12. So let's consider 1/4 now being subtracted from 7/12 once, being subtracted twice, and it can be subtracted a little bit more than twice. So this method of explaining division, which is what we've been using right along, is called the subtractive or measurement concept of division. Now let's consider a different type of division. Suppose a 2/3 acre piece of land, represented by the shaded amount of this bar, will be divided equally into 4 parts. What will be the size of each part? So we want 2/3 divide it by 4, and we'll divide the shaded amount into 4 equal parts. And we can use the 1/6 bar to see that one of these parts, that's a 1/6 of a bar, so this is going to be 1/6 acre. Notice that this example is different from the previous examples of division, because we are not asking how many times 4 fits into 2/3, but we're dividing the 2/3 region into 4 equal parts. This is called the sharing concept of division. Sharing concept of division, and this type of division will be used in the next video. We will now finish the math content of this lesson by considering a misconception involving division. Research shows that a common misconception is that division always makes smaller. Let's compare a whole bar to a bar with one part out of 12 that's shaded. So we have 1 divided by 1/12. Now this fits in there 12 times. Now we're going to have 12. Now this is the dividend. This is the divisor. And this is the quotient. And now if we were to think about reducing this amount right here, having a bar with 24 parts and one part shaded, that shaded amount would fit in there 24 times. So now 1 divided by 1/24 would equal 24. And so forth. If we continue to decrease this amount and keep the 1 fixed, keep the dividend fixed, decrease the divisor, the quotient is going to get larger. Or we can increase the dividend. We'll start in this case with 2 whole bars, and we'll fit the shaded amount of a 1/12 bar. It's going to fit in there now 12 times into one bar, 12 times into the other. So 2 divided by 1/12 is going to equal 24. So in this case, we have a dividend. We've increased the dividend. We keep the divisor to be 1/12, and the quotient is 24. If we had 3 whole bars, and we kept the divisor to be 1/12, 3 divided by 1/12 will be 36. The 1/12 would fit into each of the whole bars 12 times. So division compares the relative size of 2 amounts of 2 numbers. In these examples, the divisor got smaller, the quotients get larger. So even though we're dividing by small amounts, we're getting large quotients. In these examples over here, the dividend gets larger and the quotients get larger. And again, we're dividing by small amounts. Examples like these should help students see that you can divide by small amounts, whether they're fractions or decimals, and get large results. In this video, we looked at word problems whose quotients were mixed numbers, and one in which the quotient was less than 1. And we learned that there are 2 different concepts of division: the measurement concept, repeated subtraction, and the sharing concept. We also looked at examples to help dispel the belief among students that division always makes smaller.